This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The London borough of Croydon has a wide variety of buildings, mainly from post-war through to modern. Much of the modern architecture in the borough is centered on the commercial center of the town, with much of the Victorian designs spread out on both the northern and southern corridors of the borough. Many former warehouses and factories have been converted for other uses, changing the external appearance of Croydon. Erratically, Croydon also has a number of high-rise buildings. Most were built during the 60s and 70s. However, in the last few years there has been a renewed interest in constructing tall buildings in Croydon. Numerous residential and office blocks are being built or have recently been built in the town centre. Altitude 25, a residential building completed in 2008, overtook the NLA Tower as Croydon's tallest tower. A taller building, Croydon Vocational Tower, was scheduled to finish construction in 2010 near East Croydon Station as of August 2015. However, construction had not taken place as of 2014. There are several upcoming architectural projects in the centre of the borough in the form of the Croydon Gateway Scheme and the Cherry Orchard Road Towers. Contents 1. Structures of interest in Croydon. 2. Recent developments. 3. Future developments. 4. See also. 5. References. Structures of interest in Croydon. Croydon Town Hall, an example of Croydon architecture in 1892-1896 to a design by Charles Henman Jun. The Fairfield Halls, home of the Ashcroft Theatre. No. 1. Croydon, the tallest building in Croydon. Beddington Zero Energy Development. Bedst, an environmentally friendly housing development, shortlisted for the Sterling Prize in 2003. Croydon Sports Arena, the home of Croydon Football Club. Airport House. Ashburton Learning Village, Woodside. Croydon College. The Braithwaite Hall, used for concerts and conferences. Museum of Croydon. Croydon Central Library. Croydon Clocktower, by Charles Henman Jun. Croydon Town Hall, extended by a bridge to council offices. The Swan and Sugarloaf Public House, in South Croydon. Croydon Park Hotel, behind Altitude 25. Selhurst Park, the home of Crystal Palace Football Club. Queen's Garden Central. The Whitgift School. The Whitgift Centre. Croydon Parish Church. Harris Academy. South Norwood. The Brit School, the only state-funded school dedicated to the performing arts, media, art and design and the technologies that make performance possible. East Croydon Station. Trains to Gatwick and Luton, the busiest railway station in Greater South London. South Norwood Leisure Centre. St. John the Evangelist. Upper Norwood Warehouse. Theatre Alders, the fourth largest department store in Britain. The IKEA Towers. Recent developments. 41 Cherry Orchard Road, next to East Croydon Station, an example of Croydon's newer low-rise buildings. Central Shopping Centre, managed by St. Martin's Property Group, was completed in 2004 and includes a House of Fraser store under the Labour-run council since 1990. Croydon has witnessed a new period of construction prompted by the regeneration of the centre of Croydon. It features mainly office buildings designed by separate architects. Many of the new buildings in the past couple of years have been mainly low-rise. The Beddington Zero Energy Development in Beddington was designed by Bill Dunster. The project was conducted as a partnership between the Bioregional Development Group, the Peabody Trust, Bill Dunster Architects, Arup, and Gardiner and Theobald as cost consultants. The project is designed to use only energy from renewable sources generated on site, in addition to 777 square meters of solar panels, tree waste fuels. The development's cogeneration plant, downdraft gasifier to provide district heating and electricity. Other large-scale projects include the major Central Shopping Centre development by the Birmingham Alliance, which replaced the former C. Building. Also has solar panels on the roof. The shopping center features the high-end retailer House of Fraser, which takes up most of the southern side of the center in Croydon. The College Green area has seen the construction of a new building for the Croydon Sixth Form College, Croydon Skills and Enterprise College and the Croydon Higher Education College. Many large-scale projects are proposed as part of the Croydon Vision 2020 Regeneration Plan. One of the most recent buildings to be constructed and opened within the northern half of the borough is Penowire. 4 steel ladder masts anchor the glass box, and the whole gives the impression of a suspension bridge that stretches into the distance. External canopies cover the entrances, a cafe's open-air seating area and the approaches to the tram station. 440 square meters of glass were used in the roof and 800 square meters for the wall glazing. The architects were Alan Brooks Associates, who also made the close by NLA Tower, and the structural engineers YRM Anthony Hunt Associates, being a key destination in the south for entertainment. Croydon recently opened the Croydon Grants the Grants, towering over Surrey Street Market and in the shadow of the Croydon Clock Tower inside the main attraction is a 10-screen view cinema, which was formerly a Warner Village although there are many other attractions, including a Reflex 80s bar, Virgin Active, Nando's, Tiger Tiger and Lloyd's No. 1 bar. The building is situated on 5 floors, with the top two being used by the cinema. Future developments. Further new projects are planned for the city under the Croydon Vision 2020 Regeneration Plan. Croydon's ambition to become London's third city is a result of increased investment in the town and has led to some of South London's most ambitious non-residential schemes in the past 10 years. Plans include the construction of a new shopping centre to replace St George's Walk and older properties on George Street. The proposed redevelopment of Park Place by Minerva and Lend Lease will create a 1 million square foot destination with over 130 shops. Cafes and restaurants, anchored by a new department store which the council hopes will be John Lewis. Other tenants interested include Habitat. Borders and Gap improvements will see Queen's Gardens completely remodeled, together with the construction of a fully integrated public transport hub to include a new bus interchange and tram stop. The building of Park Place will create Europe's largest covered retail area. Croydon Gateway is the latest focus of major developments in the centre of Croydon following the demolition of various buildings there, including Wettern House. The Gateway site, a former railway goods yard which has been largely unoccupied since the 1960s, represents the largest single development opportunity in the district although there has been considerable interest in the site since the late 1980s by Stanhope. Another party has also been interested in the site. Arrowcroft, which has received backing from both the former Labour and the current Conservative administration, has made the development of any project halted repeatedly. The problem is that Stanhope already owns part of the site, and without them selling it to Arrowcroft or Arrowcroft losing interest in the site, no building work can commence. The Secretary of State will announce which plan will be granted the compulsory purchase order in mid-2008 after the public inquiry. The proposed scheme from Stanhope, called Ruskin Square, named after John Ruskin, incorporates four blocks of office accommodation totaling 99,174 square meters, a health and fitness center, a replacement warehouse theater, an urban park and 560 residential units, with 50%. Affordable housing on a 34-hectare site bounded by George Street, Dingwall Road and Lansdowne Road. There would be a 41-story skyscraper which is intended to act as the defining feature of Croydon's planned revival. Occupiers of the retail and restaurant units could include names like Carluccio's, Strada, Café Rouge, Giraffe, Las Iguanas, Wagamama, Chow Baby, Pizza Express, Lock Fine and All Bar One. Norman Foster's firm are the principal architects of the scheme. The other scheme that carries the original name has backing from the local council. The plan incorporates a state-of-the-art 12,500-seat arena designed to attract world-class performers and international sporting events. Business conferences and dinners could also be held there, and community activities encouraged through the development of a bespoke community plan in addition to the arena. The proposals include a mix of shops, restaurants, cafes, bars and a new 9,425 SQM food store. 640,000 officially become Croydon's tallest tower and one of London's tallest 20 buildings. Planning permission was approved by Croydon Council in February 2007, but building work has been slow ever since. It will be used for both educational purposes on the lower 10 floors by the college and private use as a residential tower on the rest of the 29 floors. There will also be a floor of leisure use which will be used by students of the college and residents of the tower. The building, once finished, will have a structural height of 134. For residents and businesses to see what the future of Croydon would hold in the next decade, there have also been exhibitions for districts of Croydon, including Wadden, South Norwood and Woodside, Purley, New Addington, and Coolsden. The main point of Croydon EXP07 was to showcase the projects included in the Croydon Vision 2020 Regeneration Plan to the public. One of these projects included in the expo was the Cultural Quarter. This project, devised by Howard Holdings, will include Croydon Parish Church, Bridge House, and the Exchange. It will include a new piazza, shops, and a theatre right in the centre of the Old Town. The Cultural Quarter will be situated between Surrey Street and Church Road, the oldest surviving part of central Croydon. It is all projected to cost around €29 million, and is due to be completed by 2009 as it is already under construction. The new urban space will regenerate a Grade 2 listed former pumping station and a historic market. The adjacent Bridge House will provide 74 affordable apartments and sits above a ground and mezzanine retail space. A new bridge links this building with the area's principal shopping street. The block wraps around an existing multi-story car park, creating a backdrop to the open public space. New voids are opened up under the car park, making space for shops and cafes to open out onto the square. Opposite sits a former telephone exchange that is converted into a further 66 apartments. A mixture of green and brown roofs along with off-site renewable energy provision form part of the environmental measures incorporated into the regeneration. Located in the cultural quarter, the 150-year-old castle-style pumping station is an established local icon and an attractive visual feature of the history of Croydon. The council believes the building could become an ideal base for creative businesses such as advertising, architecture, the art and antiques market, crafts, design, designer fashion, film and video, interactive leisure software, music, the performing arts, publishing, software and computer games, television and radio. These would contribute to the culture of the area. The owner, who already has planning permission for gym and leisure facilities, has expressed a willingness to work with the council to find other appropriate uses. Atkins, Walters. Carrot Bedsd. Carrot, the future of shopping in Croydon. Croydon Expo, retrieved 4 April 2008. London Borough of Croydon Districts. Addington, Addiscombe, Ashburton, Beddington, Broad Green, Coombe, Coolsden, Croydon, Crystal Palace, Forestdale, Hamsey Green, Kenley, Monk's Orchard, New Addington, Norbury, Norwood, New Town, Old Coolsden, Pollards Hill, Purley, Roundshaw, Russell Hill, Sanderstead, Selhurst, Selsdon, Shirley, Shirley Oaks, South Croydon, South Norwood, Spring Park, Thornton Heath, Upper Norwood, Upper Shirley, Wadden, Woodcote, Woodside, Whiteleaf. Attractions: Addington Palace, Croydon Airport, Croydon Clocktower, David Lean Cinema, Museum of Croydon, Croydon Central Library, Croydon Palace, Fairfield Halls, Ashcroft Theatre, RAF Kenley, Selhurst Park Football Stadium, Shirley Windmill Warehouse, Theatre Street Markets, Croydon Farmers Market, Surrey Street Market, Parks and Open Spaces, Addington Hills, Addington Park, Addington Vale, Addiscombe Railway Park, Addiscombe Recreation Ground, Apsley Road Playground, Ashburton Park, Ashburton Playing Fields, Beaulieu Heights, Brickfields Meadow, Coombe Wood, Coatlands, Duppas Hill, Grangewood Park, Great North Wood, Heavers Meadow, Kenley Common, Mitcham Common, Norbury Park, Park Hill, Pollards Hill, Purley Downs, Queen's Gardens, Roundshaw, Selsdon Wood, South Norwood Country Park, South Norwood Lake and Grounds, South Norwood Recreation Ground, Streatham Vale Park, Woodside Green. Constituencies: Croydon South, Croydon Central, Croydon North. Rail stations and tram stops: Addington Village, Addiscombe, Ampere Way, Arena, Beddington Lane, Blackhorse Lane, Central Church Street, Coombe Lane, Coolsden South, Coolsden Town, East Croydon Fieldway, George Street, Gravel Hill, Harrington Road, Kenley, King Henry's Drive, Lebanon Road, Lloyd Park, New Addington, Norbury, Norwood Junction, Purley Oaks, Purley, Reedham, Reeves Corner, Riddlesdown, Sanderstead, Sandilands, Selhurst South, Croydon, Therapia Lane and LB of Sutton, Thornton Heath, Wadden Marsh, Wadden Wandle Park, Wellesley Road West, Croydon Woodminstern, Woodside. Art and Architecture Croydon Vision 2020 Grade I and II Listed Buildings, Public Art, Tallest Buildings and Structures. Other Topics: Coat of Arms, Council, Economy, People, Railway Station, Schools. Category: Commons, VE. Buildings and Structures in Croydon: High-rises 100 George Street, Altitude 25, Apollo House, Central 1, Cherry Orchard Road, Towers, Croydon Tower, Croydon Transmitting Station, Croydon Vocational Tower, Direct Line House, Island, Leon House, Lunar House, Nestle Tower No. 1, Croydon Prudential House, Ruskin Square, Saffron Square, Taberner House, Wettern House. Notable low-rises: Addington Palace, Airport House, Ashcroft Theatre, Bridge House, Brit School, Christ Church, Croydon, Croydon College, Croydon Clocktower, David Lean Cinema, Museum of Croydon, Croydon Central Library, Cane Hill, Old Palace, Croydon Minster, Fairfield Halls, Grants, John Ruskin College, Croydon University Hospital, RAF Kenley, Ruskin House, Safari Cinema, St. Andrews, Croydon St. John the Evangelist, Upper Norwood St. Michael and All Angels, Croydon St. Peter's, Croydon The Exchange, Trinity School of John Whitgift, Warehouse Theatre, Major Railway Stations, East Croydon, Norwood Junction, Purley West, Croydon Major Complexes, Alders, Ashburton Learning Village, Central Colonnades, Leisure Park, Grants Park Place, Purley Way, St. George's Walk, Valley Park Retail Area, Whitgift Centre. Sports Venues: Croydon Arena, Croydon Sports Arena, Croydon Water Palace, Selhurst Park. Architecture of Croydon, Croydon Vision 2020 List of Tallest Buildings and Structures in Croydon.